Just yesterday, Charlotte County deputies swarmed this Big Lots after a shoplifter went to great lengths to avoid an arrest with a non-conventional escape route, which really wasn't the best hiding place.
I wanted to come and pick up a birthday card and some wrapping paper for my grandbaby's birthday.
Little did Sean Middlebrooks know, but her quick stop to Big Lots was about to get interesting.
One of the employees was standing in the open front doors, and as we approached, I said, "Are we allowed to come in?" And she said, "Well, you can enter at your own risk."
Charlotte County deputies have surrounded this Big Lots on Tamiami Trail in Port Charlotte. This woman, Christina Perkins, stole candy, toys, and makeup, then locked herself in the bathroom.
Desperation, desperate times. I mean, you're stealing from Big Lots, you're doing something wrong with your life.
It's what Perkins did next that surprised everyone.
Yeah, no, man, she's freaking gymnast over there.
Deputies say Perkins used garbage cans to lock herself inside the bathroom. She then removed the ceiling tiles and climbed up into the roof of the store.
I could see her crawling across the ceiling. The ceiling tiles were bowing as she was walking across the ceiling tiles.
As Perkins continued to crawl on the ceiling, deputies asked her to come down, but she didn't want to.
They were shouting, "Come back over towards the opening, please. Come back to the opening. You need to come down. Don't make me go get my dog."
Perkins finally came down 5 hours later, and a deputy was waiting for her.
She probably was in panic mode and definitely under the influence of something.
Deputies found 3 syringes and morphine in Perkins' purse. People who shop at Big Lots say her escape plan wasn't well thought out.
It's 2019. If you steal from anywhere, you're an idiot because you're going to get caught.
And Big Lots is not commenting on the incident tonight. Deputies took Perkins to the Charlotte County Jail. She is facing charges of drug possession, criminal mischief, theft, and resisting a law enforcement officer. In Port Charlotte, Joseph Ojo, NBC2.